So this is me at age 15 at Universal Studios Florida, sitting in the actual car from Ghostbusters 2. Now, some people love the Ecto-1A, some people really hate it. I have a special connection with this car for a couple different reasons, so stick around and I will tell you the story. Universal Studios in the 1990s. Man, the coolest place in the world for a movie fan. You may not realize that there was a big Ghostbuster attraction there in the early 90s. I'm talking about the Ghostbusters Spooktacular. It was like a big stunt show where they reenacted the ending of the first movie, like, live in front of you. It was really the coolest thing ever. You waited in line to see the show in the firehouse, and there was a guy who was hired there that looked like Lewis, who was kind of like a guide that told you what was going to happen and what you had to do, and no flash photography and all that stuff. But my story is going to take place after all that was over. I think it was 1996 or 97 they closed the doors on the Ghostbuster show and replaced it with the Twister attraction. So Ghostbuster fans would be a little bummed because the facade for the firehouse was still there, but all the Ghostbuster stuff was gone. So it was 2003. I was 15 years old. My parents decided they were going to Universal Studios. All the cool stuff was gone. They'd gotten rid of most of the rides that I cared about at that point, so it was just not the same place. There was a post on a message board that mentioned that someone thought that the Ecto-1A from the actual Ghostbusters 2 movie was at Universal Studios Florida. So I decided I was gonna go to Universal with my parents. Right when you walk through the front gate, there it was. You could see the very top of the roof rack over the crowd. I just remember like, holy crap, there it is. And they parked it right in front of the facade that used to be the entrance to the Ghostbusters Spooktacular, which was still kind of cool. This was almost 20 years ago. Everybody pretty much still used film cameras. Cell phones back then didn't take pictures, they barely text messaged. My dad at that point had a digital camera, but I had my film camera, which is actually this camera. But my dad had his digital camera and he was taking a million pictures with it. My dad and I have been looking for a car to build into an Ecto. We'd probably tried to buy maybe 5 different station wagons at that time. When we were standing there looking at that car, my dad was like amazed. I vividly remember him saying, "We gotta find an old ambulance." So I owe everything, all the high school memories, all the stuff we did in college, the fan film we made, this YouTube channel you're watching right now, it's all because of that car at Universal Studios. This is why it's special to me. Anyway, so the Ecto-1A is sitting there and a million people are taking pictures with it. You've probably seen pictures online where people have posed with it, whatever. So it's just sitting there. They've got it roped off. It was just pathetic. The rope was almost touching the ground. It was in a weird corner at Universal, so not a lot of foot traffic over there. They kind of just tucked it away. We're like, we'll put it over there. Keep in mind, Ghostbusters 2 was 14 years old. It wasn't being looked after. We had 5-day passes. I think on the third day, I opened the door and the door was unlocked. So we decided the end of the fifth day, right before we were gonna leave and drive home, let's go see if we could sit in it. We went out there. I'm really, really nervous. I'm 15, come on. But my dad's like, if they kick us out, we're leaving in like 30 minutes anyway, who cares? What are they gonna do, arrest us? My dad's just standing about 20 feet away, like, come on, do it already. And I open the passenger door. I'm kind of getting a little more courage up. Go back around, open the front door, and just kind of slide into it. I remember being really nervous, and my dad's, he's just standing there like this, and I've got the door open, and people around are like, did that kid really just do that? And everybody's staring at me, and I'm like, take the picture, take the picture, take the picture. So I shut the door, and the windows are tinted. You can't really see me anymore. I breathed, and I like looked around. Holy crap, I'm in the Ecto-1A. Dan Aykroyd sat right here. So I put my hands on the steering wheel. I'm like, this is pretty awesome. It was really, really cool. I don't know if you guys have ever done it. If you have the means, I highly recommend it. Some of you guys might be aware of what happened to the Ecto-1A. After Universal, they restored the Ecto-1. You guys can see this online and videos. They took both cars to the restoration shop. I guess they used parts of the Ecto-1A to fix the Ecto-1. I don't know. What happened to the Ecto-1A? Where is it? No one knew. I may be getting my facts wrong. Feel free to rip me apart on this. when Jason Reitman posted an Instagram photo of the Ecto-1, the picture was clearly the grill from the Ecto-1A. Because if you look closely, the Ecto-1 has the grill strobes, the Ecto-1A has the grill strobes, and under it, an amber dash laser, code 3 light, that's mounted to the lower bumper. So that Instagram picture from Jason Reitman had that dash laser still mounted to the bottom of the bumper. So now, if you're looking at pictures of the Afterlife Ecto-1, the center part of the grill, the bumper, is bent. But if you look at pictures after Universal Studios had the 1A, that bumper is bent down. I don't know what happened to it. They didn't fix that when they made the car for the movie. They kept it. I guess it kind of fit with the whole like worn out aesthetic, but that's it. Now here's a part where I might be wrong again. I've heard from people that they built two cars for Afterlife. The Ecto-1A, I'm thinking, is the car that they say was more for close-ups. Finn Wolfhard sitting in the car, like in the trailer trying to start it. That's the 1A. There's a close-up of the bumper and you can still make out those holes from the dash laser. So, methinks that's the Ecto-1A. So, I have the distinction of sitting in, I guess, both the Ecto-1A and the Ghostbusters Afterlife car. So, I got that going for me, which is nice. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was entertaining. As always, I appreciate you guys watching this. Please subscribe if you haven't. It would mean a lot to me. All right? I'm going to get going. I will see you guys later. Ciao.